In the race for technological supremacy, Russia has been quietly working on some breathtaking projects that are straight out of a science fiction novel. While America may have been the leader in space exploration and nuclear technology for decades, Russia is now stepping up its game with projects that are pushing the boundaries of what's possible, from nuclear-powered icebreakers to underwater drones capable of carrying nuclear warheads. Russia is leaving no stone unturned in its quest for dominance. But what exactly are these projects, and how do they compare to America's efforts? Let's explore some of Russia's most insane projects that make America look ancient. Arctic nuclear icebreakers. Russia's harsh Arctic climate has always been a challenge for navigation, but the country is now taking steps to ensure year-round access to this strategically important region. The Arctic Nuclear Icebreaker Project, specifically the Project 2-2220 and the newer Project 10510, began with the construction of the lead ship, Arctica, around 2016. Despite some delays primarily due to the Ukrainian crisis affecting parts supply, Arctica was launched in 2020. The completion of the entire project, including the most advanced icebreaker named Leader from Project 10510, is scheduled for 2027. The current status sees Arctica operational, while Leader is still under construction, with significant capabilities anticipated upon completion. The estimated cost for the Leader-class icebreaker is approximately 127.5 billion rubles, that is $1.36 billion. These projects are designed to significantly enhance Russia's capabilities in navigating and asserting dominance over Arctic routes, allowing for year-round navigation, which is critical for military and economic strategies in the region. Poseidon underwater nuclear drone. Perhaps the most terrifying project on this list is Russia's Poseidon underwater nuclear drone. The Poseidon underwater nuclear drone, also known as Status 6 and Canyon, was first revealed by Russian authorities in November 2015. This announcement came as part of Russia's response to advances in U.S. ballistic missile defenses, following the U.S. withdrawal from the Anti-Ballistic Missile Treaty in 2002. The project is still ongoing and has not yet been completed, with no specific end date publicly confirmed. Currently, the Poseidon is under development and testing phases. It is described as a multi-purpose, nuclear-powered and nuclear-armed autonomous torpedo, capable of operating at great depths and distances, designed primarily for destroying coastal targets and warships. As of the latest updates, none of the submarines designed to carry Poseidon, like the Belgorod, are operational yet, and the weapon itself has not been deployed. The estimated cost of the project has not been disclosed in available public sources, reflecting the typically secretive nature of military and defense expenditures, especially concerning strategic and advanced weaponry. Federation spacecraft, Oryol. Russia's space program has a long and storied history, from the first man in space to the long-duration missions on the Mir space station. Now Russia is looking to the future with the Federation spacecraft, also known as Oryol. This reusable spacecraft is designed to replace the venerable Soyuz and will be capable of carrying astronauts to the International Space Station, the Moon, and possibly beyond. This is a project by Roscosmos aimed at developing a new generation, partially reusable piloted spacecraft to replace the aging Soyuz spacecraft. This project is similar in function to the United States Orion spacecraft. The preliminary development of the Federation project began in the first quarter of 2009, and the initial phase was planned to last until June 2010, with an estimated cost of about 800 million rubles, approximately $24 million. The first stages of development focused mainly on an Earth-orbiting version of the spacecraft, laying the groundwork for later versions that could orbit the Moon or even travel to Mars. Currently, the project has progressed to the point where the first uncrewed and crewed test flights are expected to occur in 2028. Initially, test flights were scheduled for earlier dates, but they have been postponed to 2028. The Federation spacecraft is envisioned to support a variety of missions. It is designed to carry crews of four into Earth orbit and beyond, capable of 30-day autonomous missions, or up to a year if docked with a space station. There are also plans for lunar versions of the spacecraft that could facilitate extended missions in lunar orbit. Spektr-RG Space Observatory. The Spektr-RG, Spectrum Röntgen Gamma, Space Observatory, a joint project between Russia and Germany, was officially started in the early 1990s to study the universe in the X-ray spectrum. After experiencing delays and redesigns, the project significantly progressed after being restarted around 2005. Spektr-RG was successfully launched on July 13, 2019, from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan, with a planned mission duration of at least 7 years. Currently operational and actively collecting data, Spektr-RG is in a stable orbit around the L2 Lagrange point, approximately 1.5 million kilometers from Earth. The project's cost, although not widely publicized, is known to be a significant investment due to its complexity, duration, and international collaboration. Spektr-RG's main objectives are to map the entire sky in X-rays, studying black holes, neutron stars, and the large-scale structure of the universe using its major instruments, the Irosita telescope from Germany and the ART-XC telescope from Russia. Kurchatov Project. Named after the father of the Soviet nuclear program, Igor Kurchatov, the Kurchatov Project is a wide-ranging initiative aimed at advancing Russia's nuclear technology. The project encompasses a variety of efforts, from developing new types of nuclear reactors to promoting nuclear science and education. One of the most exciting aspects of the project is the development of small modular reactors, SMRs, which are designed to be cheaper and more flexible than traditional nuclear power plants. While America has its own SMR programs, Russia's Kurchatov project is a clear sign that the country is not content to rest on its laurels when it comes to nuclear technology. The Tundra satellite system, Russia's Tundra satellite system, is a next-generation early warning system designed to detect missile launches worldwide, providing real-time intelligence to Russia's military and political leaders. The network of satellites in high Earth orbit uses infrared sensors to detect heat signatures of missile launches. While America has its own early warning systems, Tundra demonstrates Russia's commitment to maintaining its nuclear deterrent. The Tundra satellite system began its initial phase of development between 2015 and 2017. It is planned to be fully operational by 2028. The project is currently in its final development phase, with advanced engineering and design work expected to complete in the spring of 2024. A final decision on proceeding with the project is slated for mid-2024. As for the estimated cost, the project has garnered significant investment, including a potential award of up to $350 million from the U.S. Department of Energy's Carbon Capture Demonstration Projects program. Furthermore, the overall capital investment for the project is approximately $1.4 billion. From nuclear-powered icebreakers to underwater drones capable of carrying nuclear warheads, Russia's insane projects are a testament to the country's ambition and ingenuity. While America may have been the leader in space exploration and nuclear technology for decades, Russia is now pushing the boundaries of what's possible and challenging America's dominance in these fields. These projects are not just about national pride, they have real-world implications for everything, from energy security to military strategy. As Russia continues to invest in cutting-edge technology, it's clear that the country is not content to play second fiddle to America or anyone else. The question now is whether America will rise to the challenge and redouble its own efforts to stay ahead of the curve, or whether it will be left behind as Russia charts a new course for the future. Stay tuned for more mind-blowing videos exploring Russia's projects.